In this installment of the City Blocks tutorial series, you learn to add urban design components to make the city blocks more believable. Objects such as benches, fire hydrants, and traffic lights, among others, are essential in an urban environment. Open the file named urbandesigncomponents.max that you downloaded for this tutorial. Here you'll find a set of objects that are typical of an urban scene: a street lamp, a stop sign, a bench, a light pole with attached traffic light and trash can, a fire hydrant, a mailbox, and a bus shelter. They are all built using low-poly editing techniques, and face IDs have been set so that all objects are sharing a single multi-sub-object material. Low-poly count is important, as you will have quite a few of these scattered. Keep that in mind as you create them. All objects have been converted to simple editable polys to reduce stack overhead. The only object that is moderately complex is the traffic light. In terms of geometry, it is simple enough, but there are three flaps that can be animated to hide or show the lights to change their status. By selecting the traffic light box, you can animate the slider to switch from a green to a yellow to a red light. The flaps are simple boxes with the rotations made to react to the slider position. These were done using the Reaction Manager, which has been covered in other tutorials on this channel. However, in case you're interested, I will show you how I went about it in a moment. One important fact to remember is that because of the nature of the Reaction Controller, if you clone the traffic light as an instance, you also instance the reactions as well. This means instance traffic lights will animate the same way. If you need to animate the traffic lights individually, which you probably do, you need to clone the traffic lights as copies. One other thing to note is that the traffic light and the trash can are linked to the lamppost for easier relocation. Also, their pivot points are set to match their parent so that they can be easily rotated around the pole. This can be handy if you need multiple lights around a single pole. These only represent a handful of urban design components. You can certainly create your own and build a larger library. One final note: the components' names have a UDC underscore prefix, which stands for Urban Design Component. This is just a simplified selection when you merge and duplicate these components into another scene. With that in mind, you're ready to move on to the next movie where you merge some of these elements into your city block scene. However, read on if you are curious about how the Reaction Manager was set up. Open the file udcreactionmanager.max. It is essentially the same scene that you had a moment ago, but without the slider to control the traffic light. Also, this scene was saved before the objects were renamed with a prefix, so that's a good opportunity to revisit the Rename Objects tool. Select all objects and choose Tools, Rename Objects. Disable all options except Prefix. Enter a prefix UDC underscore and then click Rename. Exit the dialog and click in an empty area to deselect all objects. Now all objects have a UDC prefix. Zoom in on the traffic light. Use the box tool in auto grid mode to create a box that covers the red light. The value should be around 0.275 by 0.275 by 0.01 meters. Disable auto grid when done. Using the move tool, push the box slightly to the inside so it's not protruding too much. The idea is to rotate this flap 180 degrees so that it hides or shows the light underneath. Apply the multi-sub material to the box and then convert it to an editable poly. Select all polygons that make the box and set them to ID number 1 so that they are the same color as the metal housing. Exit polygon mode when done. Rename the object UDC_TrafficLightRL001, RL for red light. Duplicate it to create a flap for the yellow light. And another for the green light. Link all three flaps to the traffic light. Next, you need a controller object. You'll use a slider custom attribute, accessible when you select the traffic light. Select the traffic light and add an attribute holder modifier to it. Press Alt-1 to open the parameter editor. You can also access it from the animation menu. Set the parameter type to integer. You don't need precision here, just three states of play, green, yellow, or red. Set the UI to slider. You can also use the spinner if you prefer. In this case, though, slider is arguably easier to use. Name it traffic light. Set the range from 1 to 3, 1 being green, 2 is yellow, and 3 is red. Set the default to 1 for a green light. If you want, set the number of ticks to 2. This makes the slider position a bit easier to understand. Click the Add button to add the custom attribute to the Modify panel and then dismiss the parameter editor. You are now ready to use the Reaction Manager. From the 3ds Max menus, choose Animation, Reaction Manager. Click the Add Master button and then click the traffic light and choose Modified Object, Attribute Holder, Custom Attributes, Traffic Light. This is to say that the custom attribute slider is now the master object. Next, select the three flaps and then click the Add Selected button to make them dependent of the master object. Choose Transform, Rotation, Z Rotation, although in this case the y-axis would work just as well. A first state has been added where all flaps are showing the current Z rotation of minus 90 degrees. Change the green light rotation to plus 90 to see the effect. This is saying that when the slider value is set to 1 to the left, the green flap is rotated 180 degrees from where it started originally. Click the state 1 label once and then click it again to rename it. Give it the name green light. To create a similar reaction for the yellow light, simply create a new state. Name it yellow light. Set its value to 2, representing the middle position of the slider, and then set the green light and red light flaps to minus 90 degrees, and the yellow light flap to plus 90 degrees. To test it, select the traffic light and work the slider. Finally, create a new state for the red light, where the slider value is set to 3 and the red flap angle at a plus 90 degree angle. Dismiss the Reaction Manager dialog when done. From this point on, you can animate the slider to animate the traffic light. In the next movie, you merge the traffic light assembly into your city block scene.